from our homes in the United States.
To the homeland of Christianity in Egypt.
To Mount Sinai, St. Catherine's Monastery.
To the islands of Greece and the holy Mount Athos.
To Eastern Europe.
Deep in the forests of Romania, with its numerous monasteries and convents. Ukraine, the ancient Pechersky Lavra.
And Russia's holy place, Sergiev Posad. We begin a modern pilgrimage like the ancients, leaving behind civilization to seek the wisdom and peace of the desert.
Egypt is the mother of monasticism. The monastic life began here in Egypt. We feel that the monastic life is backing the church, is supporting the church. Of course, every person in the world needs the calmness of the desert, not only the monks or the nuns. In the crowdness of the world, we don't see ourselves and we don't see God. But when we be in a calmness, especially in the holy places, we begin to look to ourselves, to look to the deepness of our relation with God, to feel God, to hear God.
A great monastery arose at the foot of St. Anthony's Cave. It was built in 356, the oldest active monastery in the world. It's been plundered and rebuilt several times.
We have been given the rare invitation to share evening vespers with the monks.
After a few moments, one monk jumped up and whispered in my ear, "God told me you were coming. Come up to my cave on the mountainside and bring your cameras." It was getting too dark, so we went into an ancient chapel right in front of St. Anthony's tomb and sat down to talk.
If I had the sort of love which is overflowing, Christian love, agape, which is overflowing for everybody, if I had it already as a blessing, as a grace, I could have stayed among the people. But I was weak. I needed time, I needed prayer, I needed help. For me personally to rise up from, I was atheist before I went to the monastery. So I needed to go a long journey from Marxism and atheism and existentialism, which was all keeping me, all the isms keeping me far away from God. Some people need this time to sit alone at the feet of God and feel His grace.
Is silence important to you?
Naturally.
What do you hear, what do you see, feel in silence?
Well, first of all, there are kinds of silence. Silence can mean not speaking. Stay in a place which is quiet.
Yes.
This is helpful. Like, it's nice to go into a nice forest or a nice garden where you are away from traffic.
Helping you to be quiet.
But this is an exterior silence, which it helps you, okay? It helps you to breathe slowly, to enjoy the aesthetic pleasure, mm-hmm. the beauty of the creation. But it's transient, it will not last. There's another kind of silence, which is interior silence. Now, this is much harder to find, but it's long-lasting. For example, here we are living in the desert. Okay, I'm living up there in the mountain. For long periods of time, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 1 month, I don't see any people, only when I come down here. I'm not doing anything particularly wrong. I'm not committing sins of action daily, right? I'm just sitting quietly and working and praying and yeah. being alone. But what about my mind? If I don't have interior silence, I can be as busy in my mind as if I was in New York.
So what do? How do you get internally silent?
By prayer, by Jesus' prayer.
Could you tell us about the Jesus' prayer?
The Jesus' prayer.
Yes.
Jesus' prayer is Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy.
Have mercy upon me, forgive me, help me.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me, a sinner. The short form and the long form, it doesn't matter. Now, this prayer, when you repeat it many times, okay, when you use it as a prayer rule, as a discipline, because it's the same words repeated, and because it focuses on the name of Jesus, this prayer starts to diminish, not accelerate your thoughts. Your thoughts, your desires, your plans, your projects, all of this is stilled. Okay, it will come. After you stop praying, it will come back. You have to start praying again. Yes. So what I'm talking about, the interior silence, it's a question of stilling the voices which are speaking inside you. Most of my life is struggle. I must fight against temptations. I must fight against weakness. So I actually think that the truest spiritual life is not permanent peace with calm and no worry. This can be a state of delusion. The truest spiritual life, the best spiritual life, is one where there are these moments of peace. The Lord grants them because He loves us. But a lot of the time we struggle, we fight. By this, we show the Lord that we are on the way to Him. We are doing something for Him, even as He struggled for us.
Father Lazarus says some prayers for our journey, and we're off. Our next stop, St. Catherine's Monastery at the foot of Mount Sinai. Fathers and the spiritual elder of the monastery, Father Pavlos.
Ο Άγιος Αμπάς Δωρόθεος γράφει στα σχετικά του ότι είναι το μισό της πνευματικής ζωής, η ειρήνη της ψυχής. Δηλαδή, αν χάσει ο άνθρωπος την ειρήνη της ψυχής, έχασε το μισό από την πνευματική του ζωή. Και πώς θα αποκτήσει μετά αυτό το μισό που έχασε? Ασφαλώς είναι κατορθωτό, δεν είναι ακατόρθωτο, διότι δεν θα το ζητούσε ο Θεός αν ήταν ακατόρθωτο. Θέλει όμως προσοχή. Αυτό είναι το μυστικό της. Δηλαδή πρέπει να προσέχει ο άνθρωπος και ο μοναχός, αλλά και ο άνθρωπος που ζει στον κόσμο. Μετά η εν Χριστώ ζωή είναι κάτι το εσωτερικό, δεν είναι κάτι το εξωτερικό. Είναι θέμα να γυρίσει ο άνθρωπος, να σκύψει στην καρδιά του. Εκεί είναι το μυστικό. Και αν ειρηνεύσει μέσα από το εσωτερικά, ειρηνεύει και με τον κόσμο και με τους άλλους ανθρώπους. Και βέβαια ο βασικός σκοπός είναι να αγωνιστεί, να καθαρίσει την καρδιά του από την αμαρτία. Διότι όταν υπάρχει αμαρτία, υπάρχει και ταραχή στο νου. Όσο προχωράει στην αρετή, κόβει τα πάθη, έρχεται και είναι καρπός. Η ειρήνη της ψυχής έρχεται μέσα στην ψυχή του μετά. Λέει ο Άγιος Ιωάννης Κλίμακος στο έργο του ότι κάποτε πήγε σε μια ομάδα με ολίγους ασκητάς και πέρασε και άκουσε ταραχή φωνή μέσα στο ασκητήριο. Και ανοίγει την πόρτα και μπαίνει μέσα και τους λέει: «Τι θα σας ωφελήσει έρημος εδώ πέρα? Δεν πάτε να φύγετε από εδώ?» Λέει δηλαδή ότι ο άνθρωπος θα δεν προσέξει και στην έρημο να είναι, θα τη χάσει την ειρήνη. Εάν προσέξει και στον κόσμο μέσα να είναι, θα τη διατηρήσει.